Hi, my name is Phil Frieden, and I'm an applications engineer here at IDS Imaging Development Systems. And I'm really excited to talk to you about today's Vision Channel session called How to Line Scan with 2D, also known as Area Scan, industrial cameras. In this session, I'll be talking about what line scan is, how to operate an IDS camera in line scan mode using both the Peak Cockpit GUI application as well as a Python programming sample, and also talk about some real-world application ideas. One of my favorite applications of line scan imaging are the high-altitude imaging systems used in spy planes and satellites. Some of these systems use a sweeping motion of the camera or a scanning motion to capture very high-resolution image data of the Earth's surface. And I thought that this was a really surprising and interesting use case for line scan imaging. I think you might find it surprising and interesting that you could use a standard area scan camera from IDS in a line scan imaging application. So let's jump into the topic of line scan imaging together. Nowadays, when we talk about digital image sensors, we're usually referring to area scan sensors, also called 2D or matrix sensors. These are two-dimensional arrays of pixels, and they're capable of capturing the subject in a single snapshot. This is the type of sensor you would find in digital cameras, smartphones, and it's what most people think of when referring to normal photography. Line scan imaging, on the other hand, uses a linear sensor array. This is usually one or two rows of pixels, but thousands of pixels wide, so a very wide aspect ratio. Instead of capturing the subject in a single snapshot, it scans the subject one line at a time, putting those lines together and integrating them to form the complete image data. This means that a scanning motion is required for line scan imaging. This scanning motion could come from movement of the camera or movement of the subject. And it could be translational movement, such as a conveyor belt, or rotational movement, such as a rotating cylinder. Later on in this session, I'll be demonstrating how to use line scan imaging with a rotating soda can. Area scan imaging creates images with the aspect ratio given by the sensor dimensions. So this is generally better suited for capturing subjects with more standard aspect ratios. Line scan imaging is great for very long or even continuous subjects because you only need to fit one of the subject's dimensions into the sensor's field of view. And then you can scan in the other dimension until full coverage is achieved. Theoretically, you could scan indefinitely and just continually process the image data. So area scan sensors are limited to the resolution given by the number of pixels on the sensor, i.e. the width by the height, like for example, this 12 megapixel image sensor on the right. Line scan imaging can create image data with infinite resolution in the scanning dimension. So generally, line scan imaging creates higher resolution image data. You could try to match the resolution of a line scan image sensor by capturing a bunch of area scan images, but this has the added complexity of having to stitch those images together. Area scan imaging setups can certainly have their complexity, but these cameras also work quite well in a general point and shoot manner. Line scan imaging requires a bit more complexity because the motion needs to be synchronized with the capture of each line. You can do that synchronization by matching the frequency of the line rate with the application speed. However, sometimes there's variations in the application speed or other reasons where you'll need to do that synchronization using an encoder or some other type of hardware synchronization. Properly setting the focus and setting the alignment can also be a bit more complicated with line scan imaging because this requires the full system to be up and running, including the motion and synchronization. So let's see how we can leverage the advantages of line scan imaging and area scan imaging by using an IDS area scan camera that provides a special line scan feature. At IDS Imaging Development Systems, one of our specialties is area scan industrial cameras. Some of the cameras in our portfolio offer a special line scan operation mode in which the active area of the sensor is reduced to one or two rows. Then the imaging principle is the same as the principle in line scan imaging. However, our offering of an area scan camera with a special line scan operation mode has some key differences from line scan dedicated hardware. One advantage to a line scan camera is that it can go faster. Some cameras are capable of achieving line rates up to 300,000 hertz. IDS cameras aren't designed for this high-speed line scan operation, so by comparison, our fastest line scan option is about 7,000 hertz. Line scan cameras are also available in higher resolutions. Some cameras go up to 16,000 pixels wide. By comparison, the widest line scan option in our portfolio is 4,000 pixels wide. So there are certain types of applications that require very high speeds or very high resolutions, which would be better suited for a line scan dedicated camera. On the other hand, there's some advantages to using an IDS area scan camera with a line scan operation mode. One advantage is flexibility. The camera offers two different operation modes. So that means that your application can have two different operation modes. For example, you might use area scan imaging for setting the alignment and focus, and then line scan imaging for the rest of the application. Also, IDS cameras can handle various types of static and dynamic scenes, as well as scenes with scanning motion. IDS cameras are available in a wide range of options. We have different interfaces, USB 3, Gigi, 10 Gigi, all based on the vision standard. And we also offer a wide range of form factors. So based on all this information, you may find that the most suitable camera for your particular application is an IDS camera. For example, you might choose an IP6567 rated FA camera, or maybe a modular board level design ACP option. When selecting the right IDS camera for your application, it's important to choose a camera that actually supports line scan mode. So I have our website pulled up with the camera finder filtered to show only our latest UI Plus cameras, as well as only cameras that support the line scan mode. So here I can see that there's 137 options of cameras, and there's actually even more options because the ACP cameras are located in a different section of our website under Customized. Another way to check that a camera supports line scan mode is by opening that camera's page and going to the Features section. Here you can see whether or not line scan is supported. I will now demonstrate how to use the line scan feature of an IDS camera to unwrap the printed image on a cylindrical soda can. I have the soda can centered on a turntable because the rotating motion provides the scanning motion necessary for line scan mode. For this demo, I'm using a color IP6567 Gigi Vision camera, which I have rotated 90 degrees because the rows of pixels that do the scanning are oriented horizontally on the image sensor. Opening the camera in IDS Peak Cockpit already reveals an image of the spinning can because the default operation mode for this camera is area scan, so it's already producing standard images. I'll use this as an opportunity to demonstrate some of the added benefits of having both area scan and line scan mode in the same camera by doing the initial camera configuration while it's in area scan mode. So the first thing I want to do is align the center of the can with that horizontal center line, because that horizontal center line is going to be the active area of my sensor when I switch it into line scan mode. Next, I want to do the focus adjustment on the lens. So for this, I'll be using the sharpness measurement, and it makes sense for me to stop the turntable at this point because this measurement is based on the edges that are found in the image. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to redraw that area of interest for the sharpness measurement to only be along the center line of the can, because that's the part of the image that I want to be in focus when I switch it into line scan mode. So this sharpness measurement is a relative value, so I just want to find the relative maximum. So to do that, I will turn the focus past optimal until that sharpness measurement starts going down, and then I will readjust it back up to 100%. And that is optimal focus right there. So the next thing that I'm going to do here is click the easy button to do some automatic image adjustments like auto gain, auto exposure, and auto white balance. So now we have a good looking image. I'm actually going to capture a screenshot of these settings because we're going to have to manually adjust these settings once we switch it back into line scan mode. So this is a screenshot of my exposure and gain settings, and I'm going to save that for later. So next thing I want to do is I want to do some rough calculations on the size and speed of the can. So I want to get a measurement of the diameter of this can in pixels. And so I'm going to use the measurement tool in a couple different places. And let's see what we got for a diameter of the can. So my first measurement is 2009. And my other measurement is 1966. So we'll do some rough calculations and say that the diameter of the can is approximately 1990 pixels. I can use the diameter of the can, which I just measured to be about 1990 pixels, to then compute the circumference of the can, and I get 6,249 pixels as a result. The circumference of the can is also going to be the required image height in order to fit the entire surface of the can on a single line scan image. I also measured the time it takes for one revolution of the turntable, and that's about 50 seconds. So I can use the circumference of the can and the period of time for one revolution to compute the required line rate in order to match the application speed of the spinning can with the capture of each line on the sensor in line scan mode. So for this application, I need the sensor capturing lines at approximately 125 pixels per second. When I go to set the acquisition line rate on the camera, I need to factor in the number of active rows on the sensor. So for this application, I'm using a color sensor. So I need two active rows on the sensor in order to properly capture all three channels of color information, red, green, and blue. So when I go to set the acquisition line rate on the camera for this application, I need to set it to 62.5 hertz. Back in IDSP cockpit, I'm ready to switch the camera into line scan mode. First thing I'll do is turn the turntable back on because that scanning motion is a prerequisite for line scan imaging. Next thing I want to do is stop the image acquisition on the camera because that allows me to load the line scan user set. After loading that special line scan user set, the camera is now in line scan mode, but I also need to manually enter the optimal values that I got earlier for setting the exposure, gain, and color channel settings. So I'll set these values to earlier, exposure time to 15.7, analog master gain to 1.6, and then I also need to set the individual color channel gains. Red is 1.2, and blue is 3.16. I have my image settings correct now, but I want to adjust some of the line scan settings. So the first setting that I'm going to adjust is the height setting. This height value is where you set the height of your resulting image, and I calculated the circumference of the can earlier at 6,249. You can also see the sensor height value is the number of active rows on the area scan sensor. Next thing I want to do is set the offset. The offset Y is the vertical position of that active sensor row. So this is about a 3000 pixel sensor. So I want to set it somewhere in the middle. We'll say roughly 1500 pixels. So now my scanning lines are centered in the image. Next thing I will do is set the acquisition line rate, which I calculated earlier needs to be 62.5 hertz in order to synchronize the motion of the can with the capture of the lines. I also want to point out that there's a new trigger selector available. It's called the line start trigger, and that can be used to synchronize the line capture with an external hardware device, for example, with an encoder. I'm going to leave that trigger mode set to off because I want this camera operating at a constant acquisition line rate. So those are all the settings that I need to properly get line scan working on this camera. I will click the image acquisition start button again so that we will start acquiring images. It's going to take about 50 seconds for that first image to be delivered from the camera, because that's how long it takes for one revolution of the turntable. So with the magic of editing, we're going to fast forward 50 seconds to when we receive the first image. All right, so this is really cool. We received the first line scan image from the camera. It's a complete image of the can from all sides. And that's because when you do line scan imaging in this fashion with a rotating cylinder, you're essentially unwrapping the surface of that cylinder and projecting it on a flat image. So now we can inspect the entire surface of the can with a single image. So I also wanted to provide you with a way to operate your camera in line scan mode, directly programming with the Peak API. So for this, I prepared a Python script that pretty much does the exact same thing that I just showed you in IDS Peak Cockpit. This is a pretty long script, so I'm only going to point out some key moments. Basically, the first part of the script is operating the camera in area scan mode so that we can find those optimal image settings. Around line 240 is where we actually switch the camera into line scan mode. And then a little bit later on is where I allocate new image buffers, because the image size is different when you're operating the camera in area scan mode versus line scan mode. Here's where we start the image acquisition and capture an image, making sure to set the timeout value to an appropriate value based on the line rate and image height. And then lastly, I'm saving that image to the disk. So let's see what happens when we run that script. First thing it asks me is what camera to open. I only have one camera connected, so we'll open that one. The image height we know is the circumference of the can, so that's 6,249 pixels. And then the line rate is what we calculated as pixels per second, so that was 125 hertz. This algorithm is going to divide by the number of active rows. So here's the camera doing area scan mode to get those optimal image settings. And now we're waiting for that line scan frame. I know that it takes about 50 seconds for one frame. I have the timeout set to double the expected value, which is 100 seconds. So with the power of editing, we're going to fast forward till when we receive that frame. All right, great. We're displaying that line scan frame. As you can see, again, we're looking at the whole surface of the cylinder unwrapped into a flat image. Well, I hope that was informative for operating IDS cameras in line scan mode. Now it's your turn to take this knowledge and apply it to real-world applications. There are many applications for line scan imaging, and just to name a few, defect detection is an important one. It's useful whether you're inspecting large continuous materials such as textiles or need high-resolution images of small electronics. Today, I showed you how to image a soda can from 360 degrees. You could also apply this to capturing images of entire wind turbine blades or solar panels for defect detection. Agriculture is another use case because you can scan entire rows of crops for robotic manipulation. You can use it to sort and grade different products, as well as scanning lumber for knots. And there are many types of monitoring applications. For example, maybe you just want to scan every single barcode that passes through a conveyor belt in a logistics operation. You could also use it for scanning vehicles, because the motion of the vehicle provides the translational motion required for line scan imaging. And of course, document scanning is a classic. Thanks for joining me on today's Vision Channel session. Again, my name is Phil Frieden, and it was a pleasure to present How to Line Scan with 2D Industrial Cameras.